Hey, so we're here today. We're going to have a look at some drums with Steve, our drummer, Steve Hanley from Simple Sessions. And today we're going to focus on a really well-known tune, which is a Toto song. And it's Rosanna, which I'm sure a lot of people are familiar with already. I really like that tune. It's one of my favourites from back in the day. And I know Steve really enjoys playing it too. So I think Steve's going to break it down into five stages for us. Is that right, Steve?
Yep, five stages.
Yeah. So we're going to simplify it all for you. Simple sessions, obviously, so we're going to break it down into the, I think, the hi-hat first, and then the kick and the snare, and then we're going to put it all together and Steve will explain it all for you. Okay, great. So I'll pass it over to you then, Steve, and you can show us stage one.
Okay, so stage one is the time pattern, and if anything, you know, this is probably the most important part. It's kind of, in a way, sort of what gives this groove its identity. So the subdivision that we're playing on the time part, on the hi-hats, is it comes from a triplet subdivision. So we're going to start off by playing on the first and the third triplet. So the way I like to count triplets, especially when playing quaver, or eighth note triplets, which is like what we're doing here, is I like to count the beat of the bar is the first triplet, second triplet is an and the third triplet is another So I'll just quickly demonstrate that to you now. So one, two, three, four, And the reason why I like to do that is because it means that we can count all different subdivisions of triplets in the same way. So it's one less thing to have to think about while everything else is going on at the same time. Now in this groove, what we're actually playing is we're playing on the first and on the third triplet, which kind of gives it that sort of like swung feel, because this is a half-time shuffle after all. It's kind of meant to have that sort of, that's quite stompy, swung feel to it. So I'm going to demonstrate that to you and see if you're going to play along with it. One, two, three, four, Now, the important thing to stress here is this is a two-bar phrase, this groove. That's what it's meant. That's the length that it's going to last. So the total length of the time pattern will be like this. One, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, Now, once you're comfortable with that, the next thing you want to do is we're just going to turn those triplets into swung quavers. The reason why I'm stressing that it's important to be able to subdivide using triplets, as a drummer, it's really, really important because it helps us to be able to stay in time. So at any point in any tune or any song that you might be playing, if you're able to subdivide and count triplets in your head while you're playing, it's going to really help you to not speed up or slow down. Most importantly, it's going to help you to stop slowing down, especially when playing at slower tempos. So let's just try this sort of, this next sort of like, sort of the next half of this part, as it were. All right, so now what we're going to do is, instead of counting the triplets, one, two, we're just going to count swung quavers. So it's going to be more like one and two and three and four and one. All right, one and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one. A little bit quicker. One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one. See how you get on with that and join us for stage two.
Great, so that's the hi-hat pattern, which is kind of a shuffly or swing feel on the one and the three of the triplet. And then what's stage two? What do we need to add into there now?
So stage two, this is where we add the kick drum. And we're going to add it. It's quite syncopated, actually. It's on beat one, it's on the and of two, It's on beat four. That's the first bar. And then the second bar, because remember we're talking about it's a two-bar phrase. The second bar, it's on the and of one. And then we've got a nice long gap. And then we play it again on the and of four. As like a nice little tag back into the top. All right? And I'll just demonstrate that to you now. All right? So we get that. One, two, and three, four. One, and two, three, four. And one, two, and three, four. One, and two, three, four, and one. So that's the kick drum part. Now let's put that with the time pattern, and this is when the counting the swung quavers. This is when it's really going to help with that, because it's slightly less for you to have to count or subdivide. All right, so this is when we put both parts together.
Cool.
One and two and three and four and one and two and three and four and one. So that's stage two. See how you get on with that.
Great. So we've got the hi-hat in there, we've got the kick, and then what's the next thing we need to add in for the third stage?
So stage three involves the snare drum. And we're going to be playing the snare drum on beat three of the first bar and beat three of the second bar. And this is when we start to recognise that half-time feel. And we can also hear it as well really, really clearly when we add the snare drum. So let's just get straight into it.
Yeah, cool. Right, great. So we've got the hats, the kick and the snare in there, and that's really starting to take shape, actually. It sounds like the tune that I know, Rosanna. And but I do feel like there's a couple of little elements maybe not quite in there just yet, so something's missing maybe.
Yeah, so part four, this is where we've got to add the ghost notes. These are the really quiet notes that we play on the snare in between the backbeat. And this is what gives this particular groove its real, true identity. So what we're going to do is we're just going to add a few ghost notes at a time so we can start to piece the whole thing together. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to play the backbeat on its own. I'm not going to play the hi-hat. I'm not going to play the bass drum. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to add a ghost note just after the backbeat on beat three each time. So we get that. So it's like one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four, one, two, three, four. All right. And now I'm going to add that. I'm going to add that to the groove. Okay. So now you can start to hear those things are sort of coming together.
Yeah.
So now what we need to do is we need to add a few more ghost notes. So why don't we add the ghost note that we've got just after beat four, as well as then going into the top, into that second bar. Okay, so then what we want to do is we then want to add a ghost note kind of in between every single beat of the bar. Now what we're going to do is let's break that down a little bit. So just looking at the chatter that we're getting this linear chatter between the right hand and the left hand. Right hand's on the hi-hat and left hand's on the snare. Nice little exercise you can try to really help you get your ghost note sort of feel and phrasing together. Try and play those ghost notes as quietly as you possibly can, and then play that backbeat with a little bit more emphasis, with a bit more of an accent.
Cool, and could you maybe just count that along with it as you play it, just to give the emphasis of the beat?
Yeah, sure. So, one and two and three and four and 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 one, two and three and four and one.
Yeah, great, exactly. Sounds good.
So now what I'm going to do is I'm now going to put the whole thing together and see if you recognise it. How you played the groove from Rosanna.
Cool, sounds great. That sounds like the tune to me. Brilliant. So we've got all the elements in there now, stages 1 to 5, and
yeah,
great.
Brill.